Today I'm looking at some strange properties of a magnet. And this is used in some devices that you have around your house. In fact, all of you have probably seen one since the day you were born, and you've probably got one or more around the house. You use it every day, but it's one of those things that we never think about. And it has to do with the properties of a spinning magnet and how it affects things around it. And it can do some pretty weird things. So anyway, let's get started. I will say right now, when I was making this video, this kind of looks like it might be safe and not a big deal, but the drill press can grab things. It did. The magnet will grab things and throw them. So I don't recommend doing this. For safety's sake, just watch and enjoy the video. Anyway, see if you can guess what this device is in your house that you have that uses this strange property. And at the end of the video, I will show you what that is. Okay, so what can we do with this spinning magnet? Well, let's start out with an ordinary aluminum can. I cut the top out of it. And see what it will do. I can keep it from hitting. The aluminum can will spin around. Ordinary aluminum can, not normally magnetic at all. You're saying maybe it's the air current spinning around here. Well, we can check that. You can see there's not much in the way of air current around there. Now let's look at this one. This is just a piece of aluminum. Nothing aluminum with a brass screw on it. And normally you'd say, well, nothing's going to happen, right? I'll take a piece of plastic pipe, put this in here, and if I'm very careful, it spins. There's nothing magnetic about the aluminum. I can stop it, I can show you I'm not touching it. Magnetically coupled to the aluminum. In fact, it will do strange things even when it's not to the inside. For this part of the video, I put a piece of white tape on here so you can see this spinning. This magnet is just sitting on the shaft. It can slip. The shaft is steel, so it likes to stick to it. But when there's too much pressure, it will slip, and that's important. And then I've got this V-block, which is a big chunk of aluminum, and you can see it's not magnetic at all. But it does some weird things when it comes in contact with a spinning magnetic field from this. I'm not touching this on purpose anyway, but you can hear it flipping. What I've got is I've got an eddy current that's circulating in here, and it's creating a magnetic field of its own, and it's fighting with the magnetic field that's coming out of this. So when they hit each other, they fight, and since this one can slip, it does. And even odder, when I do this side back here, it tries to push the V-block away. I wish I could show you the feeling. This is very odd. It's like this piece of aluminum shouldn't be doing anything with a magnet, right? But it does. maybe you guess what that common object is that you have around your house. It's a speedometer. And I built a model one here so we can see how it works. And we'll see if it does work. Here's our model speedometer. We've got a popsicle stick for an indicator. Here's our brass screw from earlier. Around the backside. Here's our aluminum fork that we showed earlier. There's the brass screw going through there. Here's some thread tied onto the brass screw. And at the other end of that thread is a weight, and that will act as a spring to pull our needle back to the zero position. And then of course our spinning magnet, and the spinning magnet will put between these forks. And normally this would be coming from the wheel of your motorcycle, or from the wheel of your bicycle in the case of older speedometers, or from the transmission of your car, and it spins around inside the fork. The fork will turn, and the faster the magnet spins, the more this will pull, and the higher the indicator will go. And let's see if it really works. Starting to move a little bit. There we go. Very sensitive, very sensitive. Kind of cruising along. A little faster. And stop. And there you have it, our crude but working model of a speedometer or mechanical tachometer. Hope you found it interesting.